Hello music friends, Marcel Hasser here, the Dutch guy, and welcome to LifeProc and welcome to my review of Ghosts and Memories by the Black Noodle Project. Interesting name for a band. The Black Noodle Project hails from France. From what I gather on this album, there are three musicians that created that. They've been releasing music since 2003. They have a number of albums out. And that is all I could find. The website has nothing, the Facebook page has nothing, and the booklet also has very little information. And the font I used here on the album, you know, it's all handwritten, so not always easy to read. It is a digipack, and the booklet that they put in does not really hold much. I mean, we have the cover, and we can, you know, there you have the full artwork. And on the inside, basically names of people who pre-ordered the album. It's a popular thing these days, you know, letting people buy the album in advance, even before it is made. In a way, it's nice. I mean, it's good. I mean, when you do that as a band, it's really good because you have the money. You have basically already sold the albums, so you have the funds to make them. For the fan, there is a little bit of a risk, of course, because you're buying something that you have no idea how it will sound. But a lot of bands have been doing it. I mean, Marillion is one of the bands that started doing that, and they are doing it very successfully. So obviously, well, it is a good thing. So, all right, but for those of you who are not familiar with the Black Noodle Project or think, you know, I'm a bit scared of buying an album up front without even knowing what it's like, well, it is out, so you can buy it, and well, I can tell you a little bit more about the music. I enjoyed listening to this album, definitely, but what I noticed, what they said on the Facebook page, is that they say genre progressive rock. But when I listen to the album, I don't find it progressive rock at all. I find it something completely different. I would describe this album more as a very ambient post-rock with some psychedelic influences in it. And it is mainly an instrumental album. And I gotta say, especially these instrumental parts, I really enjoyed. I kind of like post-rock. I'm not a really big fan, but I am a big fan of God is an Astronaut. I listen to some other post-rock bands as well, and I hear the influences in here as well. But I also picked up a few other influences, especially in the instrumental parts. I mean, basically the middle section of the album, if we take off the first track and the last track, the rest is instrumental. And a lot of emphasis on the guitar, but they create real nice atmospheres. They use some electronics in it. There was one track that I listened to, Shades of Tomorrow, and I thought, wow, this could have been a song by the Norwegian band Airbag. I mean, especially if you listen to the first album of Airbag, that same kind of atmosphere you find in that track. Also, in the track They Live, We Sleep, you have that same idea. So, you know, that kind of atmospheric music is what they bring. They also add in some cinematic elements. The song that is kind of my favorite song on the album is called The Owls Are Not What They Seem. That starts off with some spoken word idea, the idea that you're, you know, kind of looking at a movie but without the pictures, but you hear an actor saying some lines in it, you know, making it kind of interesting to listen to, and then you have the song, and I really dig that. I like that effect that it creates in the music. The effects that they bring, the atmospheres that they create are really good. Sometimes they are a little bit dark, a little bit haunted, a little bit eerie, like you are kind of going towards a bit of a ghost story. But of course the album is called Ghosts and Memories, so well, that should not be a surprise. There are two tracks that have vocals in them, but I say a bit retro vocals, and that is the first and the last track of the album. And those are also the longest tracks. I mean, the first track clocks over 11 minutes, the last track clocks over 10 minutes, and there's not a lot of vocals in it, but you know, there are vocals apart from the rest. Longer tracks, but still they create these nice atmospheres. And I gotta say, altogether, I found it a very interesting album. I really enjoy listening to it, despite the fact that I could not really find much. The one thing that I could find is basically what is written down here, is that we have Jeremy Grina, as I said, you know, it's handwritten font, so it's a bit hard to read, who does guitars, bass, keyboards, and voices. Sebastian Bourdeau, guitars and Fabrice Berger on drums. So a trio creating this music, and they created an interesting album. Definitely if you like post-rock, if you like Airbag, then you will definitely enjoy this album because those elements are definitely present in the music here. So, well, that's it, you know, it's not a long album, it's about 49 minutes, but I gotta be honest, when I was listening to the album, it felt longer. I mean, the tempo is very slow, especially, you know, in these instrumental tracks, so it feels like it's a longer album, but it is only 49 minutes, but still a very beautiful atmosphere. So, The Black Noodle Project, Ghosts and Memories, check it out if this is the kind of music you like, and if it's not, move on to something else and move on to something that you do like. But if you like it, I'm curious to know, well, what you like about it. And let me know as a comment here on my YouTube channel. And of course, if you like my reviews, then I would say click subscribe here. Subscribe to my main channel, you know, Life Prog. That is where I do my, well, more elaborate reviews. Here I do some reviews of albums that I don't really have the time to do a really full in-depth album of, such as this one. But still, you know, it's a nice album. Check it out. So thank you for watching. And of course, I hope you will see me at a new review.